From Los Angeles, it's the Tom Likas Show. And now, here he is, Tom Likas.
Thank you for tuning in to the Tom Likas Show. This is where America gets together to talk issues you really care about. It's a different kind of a radio talk program. We're the radio talk show that is not hosted by a right-wing wacko or a convicted felon. No, I am your host. Write down our toll-free telephone number. You're going to need it. It's 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. Dateline Reno, Nevada. The mother of a 19-year-old killed in a traffic accident is suing Coors Brewing Company, claiming that it promotes underage drinking. Jody Pisco of Reno contends that Coors has failed in its duty to protect the country's youth from drinking. Her son Ryan was killed in 2002 after he drank Coors at a party and drove his girlfriend's car into a light pole at 90 miles an hour, the lawsuit says. Now, can I ask a question here before I go any further with this story? At 19, Ryan Pisco was an adult, regardless of what the drinking age is. And nowhere, in any beer advertising did I ever see people being encouraged to pound down a few six-packs and then get in a car and drive 90 miles an hour. Never. Beer is a legally available product. Beer, wine, and spirits are legally available products in this country, regulated by the government, both state and federal. Now, I don't know how a 19-year-old got a hold of a Coors, but in the real world, we all know that it doesn't matter what the drinking age is. Anyone who wants to drink will drink. You will pull a beer out of your parents' fridge. You will raid the liquor cabinet. You will date chicks who are over 21 or date guys who are over 21 who will get you booze. You will get fake IDs. You will do whatever it takes. And I happen to believe that booze is only part of the equation. Booze, beer, whatever. I mean, a big part of the equation is wanting to get into clubs and meet other people. Get laid, dance, whatever. Be out at night. That is one of the many reasons people fake IDs or do whatever they can to get booze, beer, whatever. I am certain that unless you are completely abstaining from the consumption of alcohol, and there are those few Mormons and such that do, or ex-alcoholics, and many of them, by the way, I am certain that the vast majority of people listening to me right now had their first drink younger than 21. I did. Do you want to know when I had my first beer? You want to know when I had my first beer? Dean says 12. Brad, how old do you think I was when I had my first beer?
14.
You're both wrong. 4. They're laughing their ass off in there. 4. My father gave me a can of Ballantine beer when I was 4. I thought it was hysterically funny when I started stumbling around. I fell and skinned my knee. He thought that was hysterical. Because, you know, when you're 4, how much Ballantine would it take to stagger you? Uh-huh. Next one after that, I don't know. My grandmother used to come over babysitting, and she drank Ballantine. And never apparently cared. I mean, in my family, they just didn't care. It was just normal for kids to drink. That was it. And so I did. Come on. We all know people under 21 drink. You know, the beer companies, of course, cannot market to that audience, will not market to that audience. They, if you look at commercials, for example, you never see college students drinking beer because 21 is the legal age. Most college students are under 21. And I certainly don't see any beer advertising that is encouraging people to drink too much and then get in a car and drive. So I think this lawsuit is outrageous. But here's more on the story. The lawsuit filed in Washoe County District Court seeks unspecified damages. It accused Coors of, quote, glorifying a culture of youth, sex, and glamour while hiding the dangers of alcohol abuse and addiction. Now, can I ask you a question? Does McDonald's advertise the fact that if you eat too many supersized fries, you're going to get fat? Huh? How about Twinkies? You ever, well, do they even advertise Twinkies anymore? They sell them, but do they advertise? I don't know, but you ever seen an ad for Twinkies showing a 400-pound man waddling into the 7-Eleven to pick up six or seven of them? No. How about a Pepsi commercial? You ever see a Pepsi commercial with somebody with no teeth walking out with a 96-ounce super-duper big gulp? No. No, you don't. Their job is to sell the product, not warn you of the dangers of the product. The dangers of the product, we are getting lectured constantly about drunk driving, alcoholism, 12-step programs. We are lectured up the wazoo. You get lectured starting in elementary school. Now, they take you to those assemblies in the auditorium. They lecture you on smoking. They lecture you on drugs. They lecture you on drinking constantly. Most people I know who are drug users and who have been drug users learned about drugs at an assembly in school. That's what they learned about. The drugs these people were abusing, they had not heard of until they went to a school assembly, okay? So this whole thing about educating people about the dangers, when you are 12 or 13, you are more fascinated with trying to get away with something. So anytime you tell people 13 years old, these are the things you're not supposed to do, those are the things you want to do very, very badly. I do not think beer advertising is the cause of any of this stuff. I just don't. Laura Sankey, a spokeswoman for Golden, Colorado-based Coors, said that although she could not comment on pending litigation, the company, quote, doesn't want underage consumers, period. And she also told the Reno Gazette-Journal that tragedies like this further reinforce why the fight against underage drinking and drunk driving must continue. Says here now, and now we get to the people who might really be responsible. It says here also named in the suit were Ryan Pisco's girlfriend and her mother. The lawsuit alleges the girlfriend allowed Pisco, who lacked a valid driver's license, to drive off in her car, which had been given to her by her mother. Well, indeed, there might be some fault there. And whoever provided a 19-year-old with a can of beer, well, if you could figure out who that was, that might be another person. But the beer company is not responsible. The beer is legal. It's legal. It's legal to people over 21. Period. I mean, the beer company cannot control who is drinking beer. And certainly when they run commercials on TV, of course they're going to glorify a youth culture. That most advertising does. Youth, sex, and glamour. It's all about making you want to buy the product. That's what advertising is for, okay? It is not for warning people that if you... Why would a company spend money running a commercial saying, use our product and you might slam into a light bulb? Because the bottom line is, you're only going to slam into a light bulb if you use the product irresponsibly. If you use it in ways it was not intended. Like drinking too much of it and driving when you're 19 years old. And no commercial ever said that anybody should do that. That guy, to take Coors specifically, I have seen them run countless commercials where they have had reenactments of actors saying that, playing storekeepers, saying that we ID and we don't sell people under 21. I've seen lots of commercials saying that. So I think this lawsuit is frivolous. I don't think Coors should have to pay one penny. And I think it's outrageous to try to blame any beer company for something like this. What do you think?
God damn you!
Tom Likas Show at 1-800-5800-TOM. Thank you for tuning in. Thanks for being part of our program. We appreciate it. Here we are together again on the radio. Chuck on the Tom Likas Show.
Hey, Tom.
Hey.
I grew up in a family that there was alcohol all over the place. I mean, my father drank all the time. And, I mean, not a horrible alcoholic or anything. But we grew up, me and my brothers, you know, having alcohol readily available to us. And none of us have drinking problems. None of us go out and drink and drive and have problems. Had problems, I should say, because now I'm over 21.
Right.
But I don't believe that the beer companies' commercials are at fault for this problem. I mean, kids see commercials for all kinds of things, and they're not necessarily going to take, you know, take that for the way to live their lives. I think the parents are the ones who are the main influence on the kids. I think parents telling their kids go out and not giving them the advice is really the issue here, not the issue of, oh, my gosh, my kid saw an ad, now he's going to go out and become an alcoholic. I mean, I think that's just crazy.
Yeah, it's outrageous. And again, you know, here is what about the mother's responsibility here? You know, if this is a mere child, a teen, of course he's an adult, but okay, if that's her claim that it's all about youth here, why wasn't mom keeping an eye on her son?
Absolutely. I totally agree with you. I don't understand. I mean, I grew up, I had my first taste of beer. I was probably 2 years old sitting on my father's lap. And, you know, I was raised with the responsibility of if you want to drink, keep it home. You drink as much as you want, but take it, you know, don't get into a car afterwards. And that's, you know, that's what's kept me safe through my whole life. It was my parents being responsible and saying, fine, you know, you want to drink, you're going to drink. So if you want to drink, do it at home. We'll pay, you know, take dad with or whatever, but do it in a situation where you're not going to kill somebody. You know, if you want to have a party with your friends and drink, let us know about it. We'll clear out of the, you know, space, give you your own little area. You can drink, but nobody is getting into a car after they're having a drink. Anyone who has a drink here is going to stay here. They're going to stay the night here.
Well, it sounds to me like mom was missing. Why didn't she sue herself?
Well, mom was around, but she was not the dominant member of the household. She was.
No, I'm talking about in the case of the woman filing the lawsuit.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Like mom is filing a lawsuit. Mom is just as much to blame as anybody else, and I think more to blame than any beer company.
I would agree. I would totally agree. I mean, I understand people have to advertise, you know, and I don't think the beer companies need to be criticized for this. I mean, how many companies are there that advertise? It's standard American policy. That's pre-economy.
This is
that's
a legally available product.
Absolutely.
How it got into the hands of a 19-year-old, that's not the beer company's problem.
No, absolutely
they
not.
They did everything right.
Right. I mean, that's totally up to the parents. You know, that's if the kid is living under their household. I mean, okay, if the kid's 19 and he moves to another state, obviously the parents don't have a lot to say about what he's drinking or doing.
That's right.
But at that point, by the time the child's free and on his own, the parents should have instilled those values into the child and said, hey, you know, you're going to end up at some point, take responsibility for your actions, you know.
No doubt about it, Chuck. Thank you. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. It's Gary on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, how's it going, Tom?
Okay, Gary.
Well, I just got this. Well, we had parties when we were kids, and when a kid, we had a couple of them that were in a car accident and were killed. No one thought about suing a beer company. They just blamed the kid for drinking and driving.
That's who's responsible.
Exactly, and the parents were responsible, too, for not looking out for their kids.
Right.
That's all I have.
And I think it's time we stop looking at 19-year-olds as kids, because in every way except drinking, a 19-year-old is an adult.
Well, right. If you're legal to join the military at 17, 18, shouldn't you be...
You're legal to join the military. You're legal to get married. You're legal to sign a contract. The credit can be extended to you. You are responsible as an adult if you commit a crime, et cetera.
Right. And that's, you know, parents, you know, need to step up to the plate. And that's all I have for you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate the call. 1-800-5800-TOM. David on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom. What's happening?
Not much.
I'm kind of on the fence with this, you know. I have a pending suit with them right now, a lot of these beer companies. Every time I go out, I'm banging all these 400-pound chicks, you know. I just can't handle it. It's defamation of character. It's ridiculous.
So what happens is you realize after you sober up that you banged a fat chick and you blame the beer companies.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. I mean, come on. I'm out sleeping around with all these chicks and, you know, I'm wasted and... Everybody has to see me around these fatties, and it's ridiculous, you know?
I understand. Oh, you should sue for everything you can get.
That's what I'm telling you. It's time to get back the money that chicks took. But you know what? A lot of these companies, they disclaim everything. For instance, Banaca, okay?
Yeah.
They're, passed as a cosmetic. They're not even a consumable. So they put them in the cosmetic areas because if you have sour breath, then it's a cosmetic problem. Pepsi, aspartame, they don't tell you that aspartame causes brain swelling. It causes headaches in large doses.
Under certain conditions, I believe.
Exactly. But, you know, this particular one with the lady filing a suit, it's ridiculous. You know, it's just, it's another person trying to grab for the court change and hoping they'll trickle down to just the average Joe.
Yeah.
You know, and it's a shame it has to come to that. Because you know what's going to happen is beer prices are going to go up, and that's really going to piss me off.
Yeah, no doubt about it. We're all going to pay for this. I don't want this broad getting a dime.
Exactly.
All right, David.
Thanks, Tom. Blow me up.
Here you go. 1-800-5800-TOM. It's Sean. I'm Tom Likas show. Hello.
Tom, what's going on?
Not much, Sean.
Well, you know, I can't agree with you more. It seems like everybody wants to point the finger, but I think it was Pete Coors who said, listen, if you're under 21, we don't encourage drinking. We'll wait for your business. I mean, come on.
Yeah, they run commercials that say that. What more can they do?
Exactly. It's ludicrous that somebody's going to go after the company.
Yeah, well, anyway, of course, that's what people do. They file these frivolous lawsuits.
Insane.
And you know, you, the beer-drinking public, will ultimately pay if this moron wins.
Without a doubt. Without a doubt. That's why you're going to have to take me out bong hit style.
All right, here you go, Shaw.
Thanks, Tom.
It's Steve on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
How you doing, Tom?
All right, Steve.
I was thinking that, you know, I was trying to sue the beer company by trying to sue a car company. If some underage kid grabbed, you know, stole their parents' car or something and crashed it.
Mm-hmm.
They're not supposed to have it in the first place. It's
right.
Not meant for them. No, I think it's nuts.
Well, you know, the only time it makes sense in my mind to sue a car manufacturer is if the car is defective.
Right.
The fact that you crashed a car is not good enough. You have to prove that there was something fundamentally wrong with it.
Well,
but that doesn't stop people from filing lawsuits. They're filing lawsuits all the time, and they just sue everybody in sight.
Right. What if it was a 16-year-old kid who got drunk and stole the car? Would he sue the beer company and the car company?
Well, that's a very good question.
Yeah, that's all I got, Tom.
Steve, thank you. 1-800-5800-TOM. Taylor on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Taylor.
Huh. I just turned 21, Tom, and two great things happened to me. The first thing was I got to go to one of your listener parties, which was my first time, and I loved looking at you because I didn't know what you looked like, and I think you look great.
Well, thank you.
And the next thing was that I thought was going to be great is that I'm actually a fitness model, and I do a lot of commercials. And I thought when I turned 21, I would get to do liquor ads, you know, any kind of booze, things like that, because there's quite a lot of them out there. But when I talked to my agent, you can't do it under 25.
25.
You have to be 25 for print, for anything on air, anything at all, magazines, whatever it is, billboards.
Well, it sounds to me like they're really making an effort here.
The Tom Likas Show. This is the Tom Likas Show.
You bet it is at 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. It's Paul on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hey, Tom, I'm just calling out of Reno.
Yeah.
I wanted to let you know that this attorney that is trying to sue Coors is the same attorney that brought the case against Judas Priest a couple years back for playing the record backwards and the guy killing himself.
Oh, boy. What happened to that case? Did they settle or did they lose or what?
It got completely thrown out because it was a joke.
Yeah, it is a joke, and this case is a joke.
Exactly, and this attorney has a reputation around Reno for taking these cases.
Oh, boy. The name of the attorney did not appear in the piece, so we had no way of knowing that.
And I don't have it off the top of my head, Tom, nor would I really want to go public with it, but like I said, he's got a horrible reputation of taking any case possible, and we all sort of know him as a rat in town.
So you're characterizing this attorney as an ambulance chaser?
Not even that. Just as ridiculous as a case as you can get. He'll take it.
Wow. Unbelievable.
It probably took her 2 years just to find an attorney to take this case, and she finally found the right one.
Unbelievable.
But once again, this case is a joke. It's just the trash of society looking for someone to take care of them.
No doubt about it. Corey on the Tom Likas show.
Hey, how you doing, Tom?
Okay.
Riverside.
Hi. Thanks, Corey.
Yeah, I was calling in to say that if you're dumb enough to drink and drive, then maybe it's just good riddance to bad rubbish.
That's what I happen to think. I mean, you know what? You know what the risks are if you do that. And if you get killed, nobody should be weeping crocodile tears. I mean, come on.
Yeah, I mean, I was 19 like 4 months ago, and even then when I did drink, you know, I'd pass out in my car. I never killed myself or no one else.
Uh-huh.
So that's about all I got for you. If you could take me out with a bong toke, that'd be great.
Here you go, Corey. Jared on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Jared.
First-time caller, just started listening, and I love the show. I'm listening to all of your guidelines about what to do with women and everything like that.
Excellent.
Okay, what I got to say is I'm 19 myself, and I, you know, drink all the time. I go to bars and drink and stuff like that. But this kid's just an idiot to get crashed somewhere, you know? Like, I'm not dumb enough to drive while I'm drinking or when I'm done being drunk and crashing into something. I mean, I think it's the kid's fault.
Of course it's his fault.
And she just wants someone to blame for it.
No doubt about it. How about, lady, how about yourself? How about blaming yourself? You raised this irresponsible individual.
Yeah, I mean, my point is, look at all the ads that, you know, all the liquor companies offer. They're like, do not drink and drive. Do not drink and drive. Well, this kid was the one who did it. It's all his fault, and she's just looking for someone to blame.
Yeah, like people don't know if you drink and drive, you might kill yourself.
Yeah. I mean, it's just ridiculous for her to even try this at all. I just think it's a load of crap.
I agree with you.
But can you take me out JFK style, senior?
JFK senior style. Here you go, Jared. 1-800-5800-TOM. Holly on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Holly.
How are you?
Do you care?
Of course.
I'm doing great.
Good. And I heard you were in Portland last weekend.
I was indeed.
Well, I just moved down here from there, so that's good.
We had a lot of fun.
Good.
Everybody drank a lot of beer, too.
Very good. That's what we do up there.
You betcha, baby.
Okay, well, here's my point. So if this kid had lived through this accident and was in jail for having a DUI, would she be suing for Coors to pay for that?
Well, that's another good point. Is that going to be the new trend now? Every time somebody gets arrested for a DUI, you sue the beer company, you sue the liquor manufacturer?
Yeah.
I mean,
so
come on.
I think if he's old enough to get a DUI, then, I mean, I don't get any of it. I totally agree with everything he's saying, so...
Yeah, we're not getting a lot of support for this lawsuit, I'll tell you that. And that probably speaks well of what will happen with the jury pool, ultimately.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Hey, and I do need to say hi to my mom, who's driving home in traffic right now in Reno. So.
There you go.
Okay, thanks, Tom.
Thank you, Holly. It's Dean on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hey, Tom.
Dean.
Look, I was wondering, this guy, everybody keeps calling him a kid. I mean, he's 19 years old. He's a grown man. What's his mother doing handling his business?
That's a good question.
I mean, you know, if he's got a lawsuit, he should go get his own attorney and handle it, right?
He's dead.
That makes sense to me.
Well, he's dead. He can't do that.
Oh, he's dead.
He's dead.
Okay. Oh, imagine that. Well, that might be right.
Obviously you did not hear the story. The mother of a 19-year-old who was killed is suing, saying that Coors is responsible. All right, we lost you there, I guess. Robert on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Robert.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm okay.
Good. So what do you think about this? This case has some parallels with the tobacco industry cases, don't you think?
In a way, because I also think that if you were born after 1964, you should be forbidden to file a lawsuit against a tobacco company.
I mean, they advertise just like alcohol companies advertise, but they got nailed a few years back, so now that opens the floodgates for these lawyers to come in and try and open...
Well, it's like the morons who wanted to sue McDonald's because people were getting fat.
Oh, yeah, come on. I broke my tongue on the coffee because it was too hot.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. Take me out with a bong hit, Tom, and thank you, Jesus.
Here you go, Robert.
Thank you, Jesus!
You don't run off the FM talk station.
Tom Likas show at 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Thank you for tuning in. So a woman in Reno, Nevada is suing Coors Brewing Company. Why? Well, her 19-year-old son was killed in a car accident. And She says that Coors glorifies a culture of youth, sex, and glamour while hiding the dangers of alcohol abuse and addiction. Like you should put these things in ads. Do people who advertise cars say that if you drive too fast, you might crash? Do they say that? Do they say that if you drink too much water? How about, Dasani water? You drink too much of that, you might drown? I mean, come on. The idea of advertising is to sell the product. And if it's legally available, it's being sold to people who can legally purchase it. I think the company goes above and beyond by warning people of the dangers of drinking and being underage and what have you. How much more do they have to do? It's so stupid. It's Wayne on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, man, I got to say you're right on. This is my first time calling in, but, a few years ago there was a movie that came out with John Travolta in it about him being a lawyer who was suing these people for polluting the town and everything.
Uh-huh.
And they nailed it right on because these lawyers, these civil litigators, are so greedy and so caught up in money that all they do is they look to find these little frivolous lawsuits, like this lady. She's a grieving mother. She wants to get back at somebody for it. Somebody's got to be to blame other than her. And this lawyer feeds off of that, and he says, oh, well, we're going to go to the person who has the deepest pockets we can find. We're going to name the other parents and whoever gave him the beer just, to make her feel better about it. But he's looking at it to think that, hey, man, Smith & Wesson makes this gun, so, even though they made the gun, let's go ahead and sue them because they've got the most money. But let's add on the guy that went to the school and shot the kids,
Yeah, yeah. I mean, who gave an underage person a beer? Where's that person's name? I don't see that. Who had the party? And by the way, you shouldn't be able to sue people who have parties, for God's sake, which is another frivolous lawsuit where if somebody drinks too much at your house and then they leave and they get into a car accident, you can be sued. This is outrageous. Where is personal responsibility? Why can't people be responsible for themselves?
That's right on. I just want to hear one person just get up in front of the judge just once, say, everybody was good to me. My mom's good to me. My dad's good to me. Everybody's great. I just screwed up.
Right. Wayne, thank you so much. That word, by the way, will not be on the air, not today, not tomorrow. But what are you going to do? Mike on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Tom.
Mike.
It's an honor and a privilege to talk to you.
Indeed it is.
Hey, those Coors ads are so obnoxious and so stupid. The type of people that are actually lured into buying the beer, because they're fascinated by that, those are the kind of people that, are stupid enough to try and sue a beer company because they're too stupid to use it responsibly.
Well, the person who saw the advertisement, which we don't even know if he ever saw any Coors commercials, but it would be hard not to, but he's not the one who's suing. It's his mother. And one wonders if his mother ever saw the commercials. I have no idea.
Well, Tom, hey, that's all I have for you. I was wondering if you could send me out of Jesus Christ style with a money shot and a biatch.
I'll see what we got here for you, Mike. It's 1-800-5800-TOM.
Biatch.
And let's continue with Lisa on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi. Great to talk to you.
It is, isn't it?
Anyway, this is the first time I've ever called in, and I listen to you daily. But like I had told Dean, I am a 41-year-old mom, and I have a 22-year-old daughter.
Oh, boy.
And an 18-year-old son.
Uh-huh.
Both raised the same way. They both went to parochial school. Parochial high school. My daughter has tried everything. Drinking, you name it. My son, on the other hand, he is very academic, doesn't date, and he will not touch a drink. Family functions, it's tradition for us to have champagne. He doesn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I've always told my kids that life is about choices. You want to drink, you want to smoke, you want to do pot. I can get those available to you, and you could do it at home. Basically, I think the mother is either she's got some sort of her own personal guilt, but what would happen if her son would have killed somebody?
Wait, would she sue Coors then?
Yeah, exactly. That's my point. And the thing is that it doesn't matter how your kids are raised. I mean, it does, but like I said, I've got two, and I was always there for them, but I still worked full-time, was still involved in the school, because in a parochial school, the only way that school can make it is on parent involvement. Then also they're educated in school about alcohol. My son transferred from the parochial school to a public high school and is doing very well since we, you know, the divorce.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't afford the tuition anymore. But, you know, he's educated there, and he tells me when he's approached about anything, but he is very strong and can do it. I think basically kids need to be told that their parents are not going to be responsible for the choices that they make. If they make those choices, they need to suffer the consequences.
Especially after they turn 18 and they are legally adults, for God's sake.
Tom Likas.
The Tom Likas Show. 1-800-5800-TOM. That's our telephone number. Let's say hello here to Nicole on the Tom Likas Show.
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm okay.
Good. I just wanted to make a quick point. A lot of people don't realize is when you see the commercials on TV for the drunk driver, you know, crashed and killed themselves, or the person died of lung cancer, most of those, just about all of them actually, those commercials are sponsored by the people who make the alcohol or sell the cigarettes.
Uh-huh.
So they're doing everything they can. There's nothing else I believe they can do to stop underage drinking.
Yeah, at some point, you have to hold the person using the product as responsible.
Oh, you have to, at some point, no, it's their choice. And that's why we live in America, is because we have our choices. And if they're going to choose to drink, they're going to choose to smoke, then they choose to die if they get behind the wheel.
That's right.
So I agree with you 100%, Tom. And you have a good day.
Nicole, thank you. It's Martha on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Martha.
Well, I've been listening to your show for years, and I love you.
Thank you.
You know, the first thing I thought of when you mentioned this Coors lawsuit is, what if that kid shot himself in the head with a Smith & Wesson? Would his mother be suing?
You know, that's already been done.
Oh, yeah?
That's been done.
That's insane.
I know, but it's been done.
Let's hold people accountable for what they do.
Well, we don't.
I know. It's ridiculous. Anyway, could you take me out Seattle Mariners style?
Seattle Mariners style? No one's asked for that one in a while, but here you go. And that accordion's playing early this season. Uh-huh. The Mariners, the only question is last place or next to last place for the Mariners this year? Going nowhere. Sorry. Thank God now we're on opposite the Mariners in Portland and Seattle. Thank God. It's going to be a very long summer. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Let's say hello here to Al on the Tom Likas Show.
Hey, Tom. Nice to talk to you. First-time caller.
Thank you.
I'm just curious, what happens if I overdose on, say, crack cocaine? Who's my mom going to sue then?
I don't know. Whoever you bought it from on the street corner? I don't know.
Yeah. Are they going to sue the Colombian drug cartel? If I lose my cell signal with you, maybe I should just go sue Nextel, you know?
That's right. Exactly.
It's just, it's getting so out of hand. I mean, are you going to sue the government because the road screwed up and you crash your vehicle on the road?
People have done that too?
It is so ridiculous. They need to start passing laws, and apparently they are passing laws to where they're stopping these frivolous laws.
Well, you know, people have tried to pass laws, but they've been very unsuccessful, as you can see.
So do you sue an attorney if you lose a frivolous lawsuit?
I don't know if anyone's done that, but it would not surprise me.
Another frivolous lawsuit for a frivolous lawsuit.
That's right.
Not a problem. Thank you very much for your time.
Al, thank you. It's Mike on the Tom Likas Show.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Mike.
How's it going, brother?
Great.
Excellent. Hey, I just want to play out the scenario a little bit. I think that this whole thing should go to court, and then it'll get dropped. And I think Coors should turn around and sue the living daylights out of this lady. And, you know, and that would bring a whole new meaning to personal responsibility.
Well, I think you're right about that. And I think that's about all we have time for this hour.